Just the record, my name's Detective Superintendent Ben Fadian. I'm the Regional Crime Coordinator for North Coast Region. I'm in a position this morning to provide an update in regards to a homicide investigation that commenced on the 21st of July 2023 at the Sunshine Coast. I can report that yesterday afternoon a 25-year-old man has been charged with 3 counts of murder. This relates to an incident that occurred at Federal on the Bruce Highway on Friday morning last week. By way of background, I'll provide the following update and also clarify this, that these are allegations only and these are yet to be tested in court. So again, this is an allegation only, the information I'll provide. So about 3:30 a.m., a 25-year-old woman was located on the side of the Bruce Highway at Federal, just south of Gympie. She was located by a 65-year-old man, Mr. Terry Bishop, and she was in a state of distress. Mr. Bishop picked up Miss Satterley and drove her from that location. At that time, a stolen white Isuzu motor vehicle followed Mr. Bishop's vehicle and pursued him. It then rammed Mr. Bishop's vehicle and then caused him to spin around on the Bruce Highway. Mr. Bishop then drove his vehicle containing Miss Satterley in a northbound direction in the southbound lane on the Bruce Highway. This vehicle then continued on and continued to be pursued by the white Isuzu stolen motor vehicle. Mr. Bishop's vehicle then collided with a vehicle being driven by Miss Jessica Townsley. All three people in those vehicles were deceased. Following that, a 25-year-old man was located at the scene. He was taken to the Gympie Hospital and later the Sunshine Coast University Hospital, where he received treatment. He was later charged with offences that occurred in Gympie the day before. Yesterday afternoon, that 25-year-old man has since been charged with 3 counts of murder. That man appears before the Murujuddin Magistrates Court this morning at 8:30 a.m. I'm happy to take your questions about the matter. Okay. The information we received from Mr. Bishop's family was that he was travelling from Mackay to Brisbane for a wedding that weekend. He was travelling alone and he appears to have been a good Samaritan who's helped out a person who was in distress, and he's a victim of circumstance.
Had Miss Satterley gotten out of Rolf's car previously? How did she get to being on the side of the road?
At this stage, it appears she's alighted from that stolen white Isuzu motor vehicle that contained Mr. Rolf.
And was that before, because we understand there was a petrol drive-off a couple of hours earlier, was that after, is that correct?
We're still establishing a timeline between when that vehicle was stolen the day before and when it crashed on the Friday morning. So there's matters to do with petrol drive-offs and other incidents in between 4:30 p.m. and 4 a.m. that we're still establishing. So again, I'd renew our call to the public. If anyone saw that vehicle, has any dash cam footage of that vehicle, between those times on Thursday the 20th of July and Friday morning the 21st of July, to please contact Crime Ops Office on 1-800-333-000.
So just to confirm, Mr. Bishop and Miss Satterley were hit earlier before probably the fatal crash, is that correct?
So if I can clarify, again, it's an allegation that Mr. Bishop was travelling southbound on the Bruce Highway at Federal. We will allege his vehicle was struck by that white Isuzu motor vehicle. It then spun around after that. It was then pursued again and struck again before he collided with Miss Townsley.
How long is it believed that he travelled after spinning around before colliding with the other vehicle?
At this stage, the distance between when he picked up Miss Satterley and he spun around was about 4 kilometres.
And what can you say about the actions of Terry Bishop? He put himself in harm's way to save someone and then, ended up being killed. What can you say about his actions?
For him and his family, it's a tragedy. He's doing the right thing, picking up a person who's in distress on the side of the road, and this tragedy has befallen him.
And is there a history between Miss Satterley and Mr. Rolf of violence that you're aware of?
I can confirm. We have reviewed any interactions the police have had with these people together. I can confirm there's no reported incidents of domestic violence between Miss Satterley and Mr. Rolf that have been reported to the Queensland Police Service.
And I assume you've spoken to Mr. Rolf in hospital. Has he shown any remorse about this incident?
I'm not going to go into details about what discussions we may or may not have had with Mr. Rolf in the hospital, I'm afraid.
What condition is he in?
He's currently receiving treatment still in the Sunshine Coast University Hospital.
Do you believe he won't appear in person today at court?
That'll be for the determination of the court at the Sunshine Coast.
There was There was some talk in court yesterday that he may be moved to another hospital. Do you know?
That'll be a decision post-court with the Queensland Police and whatever his custody status may be.
And how are the victims? Obviously, we heard from Terry Bishop's family yesterday. What about the other victims' families as well? How are they going?
As you understand, the families of these victims are still distraught. Their grief is still raw. It won't extinguish for them.
Should we anticipate any further charges?
At this start, not in the immediate future, no.
And of those three murder charges, is one of them aggravated by domestic violence? Or?
Yes, one of those charges involving the homicide of Miss Satterley has a circumstance of being domestic violence homicide.
We've got another circumstance of a woman dying allegedly at the hands of a former partner. Do you think this could have been prevented at all?
What I'm concentrating on is the actions that the offender or the alleged offender undertook in that 24 hours from 4:30 p.m. on Thursday the 20th of July. We've sought information from members of the public about their relationship status prior to that. We have received some information and we're building a picture of their relationship prior to that. There are some people who have expressed a reluctance to speak to us. I would say to them, if there's any time to speak to the police, is now. And I'd give them six words. It's Jessica Townley, Terry Bishop, and Gypsy Satterley.
Why are they reluctant?
Some of the people we've spoken to don't usually speak to the police. For whatever reason, they won't engage with the police. They live on the fringe of society. I would appeal to them that now's the time to come forward and assist us with our investigation.
And so are you still searching for some witnesses to piece together?
We are. If there's anyone who has information about this matter who hasn't spoken to Crime Stoppers, I'd again appeal to them to please come forward and contact Crime Stoppers.
Do you believe that Gypsy Satterley and Rafferty Rolfe had recently split up or had an argument or anything in the lead up to the crash?
From our investigations, it indicates they had a relationship that was about 4 weeks long. There may have been some dysfunction in that relationship. As the further details, I can't go into that, I'm afraid.
And do you know at all whether he was under the influence of drugs or alcohol at the time?
That's still subject to our investigation.
What about mental health? Is that anything you're looking at? We heard some reports earlier in the week that he may have been released from hospital. His family had concerns about his mental health. Is that something you're looking into or considering?
As you can appreciate, we're delving into the backgrounds of all our victims and our alleged offender as well.
Can you confirm if there were other sightings of the stolen vehicle other than Inkara that were called into comms but not tracked or pursued?
Sorry, what was that question?
Can please confirm if there were other sightings of the stolen vehicle other than the one at Inkara that were called into comms but not tracked or pursued?
We've received information from members of the public who have sighted that vehicle, so we've taken statements from those people. So yes, other members of the public did sight that vehicle. They may not necessarily have contacted police about it though. We've reviewed a large amount of dash cam footage, closed circuit television footage, traffic and main roads camera footage, and also calls to police communications. I won't go into the specific details about that, but we're in possession of a large amount of data and information about what's occurred in the lead up to that.
And I think the question was asked earlier, but it may not have been answered, from the point at which that initial crash happened on one side of the Bruce Highway and then Terry and Gypsy went up the other side of the Bruce Highway. How long were they travelling northbound in the southbound lane? Do you know?
Look, okay, I can confirm they didn't go over and cross over onto the other side of the highway. They're on the incorrect side of the highway, for want of a better term, travelling northbound in the southbound lane. So it was a matter of under 2 minutes that they're travelling northbound, though.
So under 2 minutes from spinning around to travelling north.
Correct. As you can appreciate, it was a dynamic situation and quite chaotic. I won't go into further details specifically about that, but they only drove a short distance, approximately 4 kilometres south on the highway, before they turned around and travelled shortly northbound.
But in the south lane?
Yes.
And in terms of, it was a pretty horrific crash scene. How was it for first responders and how police and other first responders dealing with
seeing
that level of
crime? Yeah, it's confronting for the first response police and the Queensland Ambulance Service officers who attended. Have they been provided internal support by both organisations?
Thank you.
So Rolf is appearing in court in person?
Oh, I can confirm he's been scheduled to appear at the Maroochydore Magistrates Court. Whether he'll appear in person will be a question for the court at the Sunshine Coast, given his status in hospital.
So he might not be clear of hospital at that point?
Correct. Any further questions? All right, thank you.